I hope these conditions are clear to you. If not, please pause the video, look back, understand the arrangement, understand the question, and then proceed further. Because let me warn you at this stage, the further you go, the more complex it becomes without your understanding. If you understand, things become very clear and easy. Now, the conditions are done. Now, the next question is, what is N of C1? N of C1 are those permutations where couple 1 are sitting beside each other. We don't know anything about couple 2 and couple 3, right? Observe this. You have this circular table. I consider the husband and wife, couple 1, as one single object. Now, two people out of the six people, three couples and hence six people. Two people are considered as one unit, one object. Now, how many are remaining? Four are remaining. I will name them like this. P1, P2, P3 and P4. You see, we have five distinct objects here. Earlier we had six people. Now we have toned it down to five. How? I am considering couple one as one unit. Now, in N of C1, you have those permutations where couple one sit beside each other. I have locked couple one now. The remaining four are like this. Let me enumerate some of the possible permutations. It is something like this. C1, P1, P2, P3, P4. This is one permutation. Another one could be something like this. P1, C1, C2, C3, C4. This is another permutation. P1, C1, P2, P3, P4. And this is another one. P4, P3, C1, P2, P1. This is another permutation. Well, there are several like this. How many are there? Let us see. You see, all possible such permutations are 5 factorial in number. How? We had 5 distinct objects, C1 as one unit, P1, P3, P2 and P4, these as 4. So 4 plus 1, we had 5 objects, and all possible permutations of these 5 objects are 5 factorial. Right? But don't you think we are overcounting here? Let us understand what we are overcounting actually. Observe this. C1, P1, P2, P3, P4. Don't you think it is the same as P4, C1, P1, P2, P3? Please observe very carefully. How is it the same? C1 is one unit, right? When you rotate it, you can write it down on a pen and paper. Write down these five as in a circular format. Give just one rotation. Don't you think you would get it as P4, C1, P1, P2, P3? It is the same. And what did I mention earlier? I had mentioned that rotations are not considered as different permutations. And hence, this is the place where we are overcounting. There will be several such rotations. Now, the next question is, how do we count such extra permutations? Rather, we do not want such permutations. And how do we come to know how many of these are there? Let us see. Now, this is the place where bijection will come to our rescue. How? Observe very carefully. P1, P2, P3, P4. I'm just taking these four. Leave out C1 for now. Observe this. P1, P2, P3, P4. I have these four. I'm going to take it to C1, P1, P2, P3, P4. What did I do? I just appended C1 along with this permutation. I had a permutation. I appended C1 to that permutation. Now, consider. So C1 here was appended. Consider another such permutation, P3, P1, P2, P4. This is some random permutation. What is it going to? According to the previous rule or mapping, there was a permutation. I just appended C1 along with that permutation. Now, according to this mapping, where will P3, P1, P2, P4 go? It will go to C1, P3, P1, P2, P4. Isn't it? Now, I can give you any such permutation and you can close your eyes and map it to C1 appended to that permutation. Well, till now, things must be very clear. Now, the next observation we make is, how many such permutations do we have? Right? We have four objects here, four people. I'm considering it to be four objects. Four objects, all possible permutations of four objects, 4 factorial in number. So, do you see that the domain has 4 factorial elements? Now, observe something. I am going to consider one element in the codomain. How? I am going to consider this element. P2, P1, C1, P4, P3. I have considered this permutation of 5 objects. C1 and the other 4, right? P2, P1, C1, P4, P3. Don't you think it is the same as C1, P4, P3, P2, P1? Please observe very minutely here. We haven't changed anything. It is rotation again. If you observe carefully, I have just rotated and got it as C1, P4, P3, P2, P1. You can probably write it down as a circle and check it. Now, if this element is there in the codomain, from where did it come? I can take it back to this element. P4, P3, P2, P1. How did I do this? See, this element here in the codomain had C1 appended to this permutation, right? Now, given any such permutation in the codomain, don't you think we can obtain a corresponding element in the domain? Yes, we can. And hence, how many such elements are there here as well? It must be 4 factorial. Why? I have just proved to you that this is a bijection. It is 1-1 as well as onto. It is a proper bijection. Right? Did you see how ingeniously bijection came to our rescue here? So, I had earlier asked you how many such overcounts did we do? How many such elements did we count more than once? 4 factorial is the number. So, 5 distinct objects can be arranged around a circular table in 5 minus 1 factorial, which is 4 factorial ways. Now, I can write it as, in general, n distinct objects can be arranged around a circular table in n minus 1 factorial ways. You can probably box this and keep. It will be useful for our further steps. So, n of C1 happens to be 4 factorial. But can I stop at this position? I cannot still conclude that 4 factorial is the answer. How? You will appreciate it after this step. You observe, couple 1 can either sit as husband-wife or wife and husband, and hence it is 2 into 4 factorial, because For every permutation, this is possible. You consider C1, P1, P2, P3, P4. There itself you have two, either WH or HW. For every such permutation, two sub-permutations are possible, and hence it is 2 into 4 factorial. This entire story was for couple 1. Now the story continues for couple 2 as well. What does it mean? N of C2 happens to be 2 into 4 factorial, N of C3 happens to be 2 into 4 factorial as well. Well, we have observed that N of C1, N of C2, N of C3 happen to be 2 into 4 factorial. Now, let us see what is N of C1, C2, C2, C3, C3, C1 in the next video. You must probably really want to write down things. Watch the video several times here and there to understand the example clearly.